Ransomware is one of those digital nightmares we all hope to avoid but can't seem to escape, no matter how careful we are. At its core, ransomware is a type of malware that locks up your files using strong encryption. Once it's done encrypting everything, you get a message telling you to pay up if you ever want to see your files again. The ransom is usually paid in cryptocurrency because, you know, keeping things anonymous makes everything feel a little more shady. The ransom amounts vary, anywhere from a few hundred bucks to millions, depending on how valuable your data is to the attacker. If you're a business, that's a pretty massive headache, since losing access to critical systems can cause a lot of downtime, loss of revenue, and even major reputational damage. For individuals, it could mean losing irreplaceable stuff like family photos or financial documents. So yeah, not great. Now, let's talk about how ransomware works. First, it sneaks into your system, usually through phishing emails or by exploiting vulnerabilities in your software. Once it's in, it starts encrypting your files. These are often important files, the ones that are essential for your work, your business, or your personal life. After it's done, the attacker sends you a ransom note, demanding payment to decrypt everything. The problem is, even if you pay, you're not guaranteed to get your files back. And paying only fuels the fire, encouraging the cybercriminals to keep at it. Ransomware has been around for a long time. It started way back in the late 80s with something called the AIDS Trojan, which was spread via floppy disks. Remember those? The ransom was a small sum, around $189. But the concept was born. Fast forward to more recent years, and things have gotten way more sophisticated. Take the WannaCry attack in 2017, for example, which spread to over 200,000 computers in 150 countries. Or the Colonial Pipeline attack in 2021, which caused fuel shortages across the eastern US. These attacks show how ransomware can have a global impact, and not in a good way. The evolution of ransomware is like watching a virus mutate. It gets more targeted and more dangerous. For instance, in 2013, CryptoLocker made its debut and really upped the game with strong encryption and Bitcoin as payment. Fast forward to 2021 and we see the rise of double extortion, where attackers encrypt your data and then steal it, threatening to release it unless you pay. It's not just about locking your files anymore, it's about causing more chaos. And in the last few years, we've seen the rise of ransomware-as-a-service, RAS, which is basically cybercrime as a business model, allowing even non-tech-savvy criminals to jump in on the action. So, how do you avoid becoming a target? First and foremost, you need to back up your files regularly. Having a backup means you won't have to pay the ransom if you're hit. Keep your backup offline or in a secure cloud storage space. Next, keep your software up to date. Many ransomware attacks rely on vulnerabilities in outdated software, so updates are essential. And of course, using security software like antivirus and anti-malware programs can help spot ransomware before it takes hold. But let's be real, even the best defenses won't stop everything, so make sure your employees or anyone else with access to your system knows how to spot phishing emails and suspicious links. A little awareness goes a long way. But let's say you've already been hit, what now? First, isolate the infected system to stop the spread. Disconnect it from the network, disable Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, and try to figure out which ransomware you're dealing with. Once you know what you're up against, you can search for decryption tools or figure out the next steps. If you've got backups, restore from those, simple as that. But if you don't, and you're thinking of paying, remember that there's no guarantee it'll work, and paying just encourages more attacks. Instead, your best bet is to use reputable security software to remove the ransomware, or if needed, try manual removal by getting rid of the malicious files and registry entries. Let's wrap this up with a bit of a silver lining. While ransomware is a huge threat, you don't have to be helpless against it. By staying informed, following best practices, and using the right tools, you can minimize the risks. If you want to dive deeper into this stuff and level up your skills, I've got a fantastic cybersecurity community on my WAP store. I offer courses, quizzes, and a Discord full of awesome hackers. It's a great way to stay sharp and learn more about defending against all kinds of cyber threats. So if you're serious about boosting your cybersecurity knowledge, join the community and let's tackle this stuff together. And before I sign off, I want to hear from you. Got any thoughts on ransomware? Maybe a story to share? Drop it in the comments. Stay safe out there.